Hello friends, today we are going to highlight on the topic which is very relevant to all classes, mainly in the high secondary level and also in the college level. The topic is, as written on the board you can see, it is the structure of covalent molecules and ions, which is also known as Langmuir's formula, and I have written the notation ABMEN model. Let me tell you what is the meaning of A. A stands for the central atom or the central element having lower electronegativity or higher atomic number. B stands for the terminal atoms. It can be one or more than one. M is the number of B atoms. E, as you can see, is the lone pair, and N is the number of lone pair. Now for solving this, we need to take an example. Let us take a very good example. Say we take HCF2. So here A we take as xenon, B we take as fluorine, M we take 2, N, which is the number of lone pair, is unknown. So how to solve this out? Now I can also give you another hint. M plus N, this is called occupancy number. Now from literature we have some data where we can find this occupancy number and predict the structure of the covalent molecule. So first of all, if we find the total number of valence shell electrons of xenon, that is 8. All of you know that xenon is in group 18, so it has 8 electrons in its valence shell. Next is, this is part A, part B. Number of electrons consumed by two monovalent fluorine atoms. Dear students, I must point out something over here. If B atom anywhere is oxygen or sulfur, take them as bivalent. Remaining all are monovalent. Next comes remaining number of electrons, that is total minus consumed, that is 6. Now how to find the number of lone pair? You know that each lone pair contains 2 electrons, so if we find the number of lone pair, that is we have to divide by 2, so we get 3. So therefore M plus N gives you the how much? 2 plus 3, that is 5. Now if occupancy number is 5, the geometry is TBP, hybridization comes to be sp3d. You can just count 1 plus 3 plus 1 gives you 5, s1p3d1. Now you know that sp3d has a trigonal bipyramidal geometry, which is something like this. This is a trigon. At the center I put the xenon, and the two fluorines are placed axially, and the lone pairs are placed on the equatorial plane. You know why the lone pairs are placed on the equatorial plane? The equatorial plane, the lone pairs are at 120 degree with respect to each other. So to minimize the lone pair repulsion, it is placed in this way. So if we now say what is the shape of the molecule, lone pair has to be excluded. This is very important. Lone pair has to be excluded. We must exclude the lone pair. So if we exclude the lone pair and only include the bond pair, the geometry comes to be linear. So this is very important. What is geometry and shape and what is structure? Structure includes everything, the bond pair as well as the lone pair. But when we are talking about the shape, we should only take the bond pair. So many examples are there. So you can practice at home. I can give you some practice examples like HCOF4, HCO2F2, HCO3, HCF4, all xenon compounds. So you can practice this and you can get your result. Now students, let us do one example which I have given you for homework. So HCOF4, I have set this example. Following the same logic, we will do A will be xenon, B will be oxygen and fluorine both. Okay, because in that case, in case of xenon fluoride, there are only one type of B atoms, but here you find two different B atoms. And note here, one atom, B atom, is oxygen, which is bivalent, and another B atom is fluorine, which is monovalent. Now what will be M? M will be 4 plus 1, that is 5. What is N? N we don't know. Again, following the same logic, total number of valence shell electrons of xenon, which is 8. Next, number of electrons consumed by one bivalent oxygen, that is 2, and 4 monovalent fluorine is 4. 4 into 1, 4. So what is the total consumed? The total consumed is 6. So what is the remaining number of electron? It is 8 minus 6, that gives you 2. Again the same logic, one lone pair has 2 electrons, so we are finding N, that is the number of lone pair, so it will be 2 by 2, that is 1. So what is the occupancy number? I think students, you still remember what is M plus N. It is called, sometimes it is also called coordination number. So M plus N here comes to be 5 plus 1, 6. So 6 stands for octahedral geometry. Hybridization, obviously you know, 1 plus 3 plus 2, that is sp3d2. Now let us draw in the octahedral pattern. At the center of the square plane, I put xenon, I put 4 fluorines on the equatorial plane. Oxygen is bivalent, so it will be doubly bonded like this. And where to place the lone pair? What is the sixth site? Coordination site is this one. So it is, why I have put some dots? Because it's a 3D view. So it's apparent that the lone pair is emerging from beneath the square plane. Now what will be the structure of this molecule? Now it is distorted octahedral, but since we are more interested about the shape of the molecule, so if I join this, what type of shape you are getting? On a square you can see a pyramid like this. So it is square pyramidal. So here ends the Langmuir's formula. It's very unique. You can find the hybridization, you can find the structure. So students, I just tell you, if you have any queries, if you have any comments, so you just write your comments, I will answer. And if you like the video, you just share it, you like it, and you do subscribe. Thank you.